Creating customer types. So in this video, I'm going to take you through how to create some customer types. This may be used for future kind of marketing purposes so that you can then monitor what types of customers that you're getting and what kind of transactions they're doing. So first of all, let's show you how to set up those types. We're going to go up to our toolbar in 4D and actually go first to our server preferences. So clicking on File and then going down to your server preferences. And on your main general page or tab, in your preferences, you'll notice you've got some checkmark options onto the right-hand side. So there's Ask Customer Type in Invoice. Must make sure that we first select and check this box so that when we create our invoices going forward, it's going to ask for customer type to be filled in. So now that we've done that, I'm going to click on Save. And I'm going to take you through how to actually create those customer types. So we need to open up the customer types module. So going to your drop down in your modules and finding customer types and then select, you'll see that we don't actually have any customer types as yet. So this is the module where we can create those. So up onto your toolbar, we can click on New. And this is where we can now create those codes and what type of customer that will be associated with it. So for example, say you want to put one for students, you can make up your code for students and then obviously calling it students and save. And let's make a couple more. So let's say we want to also track tourists, so you can make up your code for tourist. And local businesses, let's say. And maybe you have one for friends and family. So when I go up to the toolbar and click on New, you can see all of the ones we've just created. They also have a customer code associated with them because that will be what will be used in your invoice. So those are now created. So let's show you what that looks like when we actually do a transaction. So going to our invoice module, and we want to create a new invoice. So clicking on New on the toolbar. Now these customers don't necessarily have to be associated with anyone who has a profile. They can be walk-in customers. So we'll leave it as a walk-in customer. And you'll see on the right-hand side at the top, we now have a new field, Customer Type. Now this would not be on the invoice if we hadn't first gone into our server preferences and checked that box to make sure that it asks for our customer type first. And once in this field, we can now put in what we just created. So let's say it was a student that just came in. We can put in the code STU, tab down, and you'll see that it's brought up students as the type. We can then continue and just do a transaction. So let's just say that we did 100 euros. And I'm just going to pay that off right now. And then we can click Save. So that is one transaction. So let me take you back in and we'll do another transaction. This time, say you don't remember your customer type code. That doesn't matter. You can type in a word that's associated with that code and it will bring you to the drop-down where you can then select from. So let's say we can't remember what the local business code was. So we can just put in local. Then we hit tab and you'll see it's brought us to a selection. And obviously the only one that matches with local is our local business. And it shows you the code on the side. Let's say we type something in and it doesn't actually bring up anything. We can then actually create a customer type right here on this page. We can go down to the Add New Customer Type and add in another one that wasn't there and then select it. But for this one, we want to do the local business, so we can either select and pick or double click. And then we can continue to do our transaction, so whatever that may be. So that is how you create your customer types and apply that into an invoice so that going forward, if you need to do some reporting for marketing purposes or whatever you need to report on, you can then report based on that data.